sorry, I'm Princess Ilka. Yes, I'm still in the Monte Cassino house. Let me continue doing a little bit here. So the house right there, right? Entrance. Now, these large stairs from behind the kitchen. Oh, you could actually walk by it. You could walk from... okay, so wait. Go. So here's the entrance. You could walk. Let's make it a little bit thicker, okay? Wait, so what I wanted... Here's the entrance. There is a window. So you could walk right here. And you could walk right here. Yeah, next to the bathroom window. That was a large window, but there was also a curtain inside. You could walk, and then you could take the stairs down. So you can walk right there. And yes, you could walk the stairs down and then enter the office from below. Yeah, inconvenient, the office, because I don't like the workers to watch me as I'm in the garden. But I never spend much time in the garden, only on Sundays. And now I mowed the lawn, man, can you believe it? No, inside joke. I did mow the entire thing with a manual lawnmower because Pavarotti was not for anything, man. Because I like my space, nice. So, you could walk down here and... Here there would be a grill built in next to the wall. And that was a terrace, remember I told you a terrace. Now here's the end. And there was a bench integrated. You could sit here. So that was the end. And then there was a planter, like I described. This is a planter. So this was higher up and this was a slope going down. Tiny bit, yeah, less than the size of a human being, maybe a midget, or it's yeah, half a human being go up. And was it stairs here? I don't remember. Yeah, I think it was stairs right there. So terrace integrated grill. Yeah, of course it's not a gas grill, man. It's Mexico. It's just grill. Yeah, probably wouldn't grill. He wasn't up for anything, man. And enough space to display a buffet or something. Good for a little party for outdoors. So here you could sit, and there was a planter, and it was like a triangle-shaped planter. How did I do that now? Wait. Okay. And these were planters too. In that planter, I had planted a tree. A ficus tree. Because I bought that ficus tree when I spent the first Christmas with Pavarotti. And that was the first Christmas, and then the next year we went to blah blah, and then the following year we moved into this house. And I don't know, it felt so symbolizing because it was our Christmas tree, a ficus, revolutionary. Yeah. I mean, I don't mind and he doesn't mind and that kind of bond us in a way because we don't give a shit that couldn't be a pine tree. We're in Mexico, man. In Cuernavaca, what do you want with a pine tree? And I'm not up for chopping off trees, particularly not when there's not so very many. So the ficus was in a planter and then was in a planter. And here I actually planted the ficus tree. No, it's not a good one. I'm intending to make memory how this worked out with the triangle shape. So I lived here for 3 years in this house. 3 years. And of course I did the move. Pavarotti was sitting fat-bellied in his office chair somewhere in the next office. And I did all the move. And that is when the ficus tree story happened. So I did all empty. Now I had a large garage sale right here in the entrance. Got rid of most of the stuff I had before I moved out. All the people in the neighborhood would come. It was very concurred because they had not much chance to go anywhere and buy anything. And as I emptied the house and was done and I was just about to exit the house. I looked one more time and there was a shovel laying. So I thought, okay, this is the time. So I went with my shovel to the planter and decided an ultimate minute to take the ficus tree out and take it with me because it had such a memorable value to us. Or to me, at least, it did. And the ficus tree, but this had now developed a root this large. Look at that, my in-between, this large. And I had such a super hard time to take the ficus tree out. One root. So I said, and really I'm not religious and nor do I pray to God, but I thought in this very moment, if God wants me to have the quercus tree, I will be able to dig it out. Boom, 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 and the root got chopped. So I grabbed the ficus tree, which was now larger than I was, right? I just dragged it all the way up the stairs. There were my cars. Actually, I think I had the car part. No, couldn't be. I put it in the car. I mean, it barely fit in that little thing I had. And I took it to the new house. And I went to the new house. And I dug it a hole in the dirt. I picked a place. I put the ficus tree in. I covered it all up. I watered the ficus tree. And it never, ever, in all these days, never lost one leaf. That was like a symbol of God. And because they're so delicate, these ficus trees. And as I was finished with my move and the ficus tree was such an adventure, I took a shower. Now I put on my nice dress. And I went to see like Robin, right? Not Robin, but the group of Robin, the moms. And it was so weird because I entered this place. And it's like in Mexico, you'd say, well, aquí no pasó nada. Like I entered like nothing ever happened. And something really tremendously large had just happened. But no one was susceptible to notice anything about anybody in particular, not about what I had to say or what I was up to. No one was really interested in anybody. And I thought, man, they're like, they're sitting here. Les pasa por desapercibido. Look like life passes by them and they don't really acknowledge anything. And it's like, it's totally not my crew or my crowd. That I don't know how to say it. It's like so outrageous what I just endured, and they have no clue, not even the remotest idea, and that would probably not actually be very inviting if I would tell them, because they would not understand the magnitude of that ficus tree transportation or what I just endured, because I never moved a finger, the shit. And so I kept it to myself. Unless I heard they didn't know anything about me, they did not know anything about me. Nothing. No one knew anything about me because I did not have any interest. And maybe then I had not studied, so that I understood that I am, you know, licenciada in Relaciones Internacionales. I'm licensed in international relationship from university and all these things I had. So many other things I had in languages I spoke, I had no idea. And that's not really a kind of friendship I could call friendship.